This conference will now be recorded.
Hi, this is Venkat. Today I am going to explain some of the interview questions. So first one, what is the use of union transformation? Union transformation is an active transformation and it is mainly used to combine data from multiple sources. You can combine data from flat file, flat file table, flat file XML. So you can combine data from multiple heterogeneous sources. Whenever you want to merge the data from multiple sources, you can use union transformation. What are the prerequisites to use union transformation? In order to use union transformation, the number of ports between sources should be same. Suppose in source A you have 10 ports, in source B also you should have 10 ports. Number of columns or ports should be same. The data types also should be same, and also size of the ports should be same. So union transformation output is unional. How to get union result? So when you use union transformation in Informatica Power Center tool, the output is unional. Unional means it won't eliminate any duplicates. So how to the union will help to eliminate duplicates? How we can achieve? So after union transformation, you can put SATA transformation, and in the SATA transformation properties tab, you can enable distinct option. So in that way, you can eliminate duplicates and you can get the union result. How do you justify union is an active transformation? The way the input receives from different sources, the union transformation, the output order is not same. So that's why union transformation is an active transformation. The input order from the union transformation is not same as the output order of the union transformation. Can we use union if two sources have different number of columns or ports? As we know, the prerequisite is same number of ports or columns should be in each source. But there is a flexibility. Technically, you can do. Suppose in source A you have 5 columns, in source B you have only 4 columns. Then add an expression transformation and create one dummy port with the other source, same data type, size. In that way, you can use union transformation. What is the use of stored procedure transformation? The stored procedure transformation is generally used if you want to call any PL SQL procedure. In general, we try to implement the business logics using existing Informatica transformations only. If the business logic is very complex and not able to implement using existing Informatica transformations, then only you write a PL SQL procedure. To call that PL SQL procedure, we go for stored procedure. When we go for stored procedure, generally we go for stored procedure, the business logic is complex, one scenario. Another scenario, in a real-time environment, some people use before loading data into target table, you want to perform some operation, or before reading data from the source, you want to perform some operation. In such cases also, we go for stored procedure. What are different types of stored procedure transformation? We have two different types of stored procedure transformations. One is connected, another one is unconnected. Like lookup, we have connected stored procedure and unconnected stored procedure. When we go for unconnected stored procedure transformation, in general, we go for unconnected stored procedure transformation if you want to call the same stored procedure multiple times for a single row. In such cases, you go for unconnected stored procedure transformation. For a single row, you want to call multiple times. How many ways you can call stored procedure from unconnected stored procedure transformation? Suppose you have written a PL SQL procedure. So you want to call from unconnected stored procedure. There are different ways. So using call text, you can call before source read, after source read, before target load, after target load. Those are different types of options available in unconnected stored procedure transformation. So how do you call unconnected stored procedure transformation? Suppose if you are using unconnected stored procedure transformation within a mapping, or you are using you want to call for every row. So in that case, you have a syntax of colon sp dot stored procedure transformation name followed by arguments. If you want to call the stored procedure transformation from expression, then this is the syntax: colon sp dot stored procedure transformation name with arguments. So if you want to call before source read or before target load, then you can use call text option. How can you improve the performance of unconnected stored procedure? If you are calling unconnected stored procedure from expression, then you can decide if any of the input parameters are null, then obviously it will return null only the output. So you can put a condition IIF if all of the input ports are null, then you need not call the unconnected stored procedure transformation. So in that way, you can decrease the number of calls to the unconnected stored procedure, and then you can improve the performance.